Hey guys, Brian here. Welcome back to Not Quite the Shop. I'm going to do something today I don't normally get to do, and that's work on something I want to work on. So, it's getting ready to be fall harvest time, and I want to get this tractor going to pull wagons with. And I've had issues with the carburetor on this pony motor lately, getting this thing started. So, I'm doing some modifications here. I had coated this tank at one time, because rust and stuff gets down in this carburetor and stops it up, and that's been an ongoing problem over the last 20 years. So, the coating, I used a 415 tank sealer, and it didn't hold up real great. It's flaked off and come loose inside, and I've scraped it all out, doing away with that. Didn't pan out for this application. Maybe if I'd have run some acid wash or something through it first to get something working bind good inside. I had put ball bearings in it, shook it up, and tried to beat all the rust off, but it didn't hold. So that was a failure. But I've got this inline fuel filter set up off of an old Chevrolet inline 6, and I've managed to come up with a fitting configuration to get it plumbed over underneath here. So I'm going to get that. Hopefully that'll solve this problem. Sediment bowl will be able to capture the rust, and the filter will keep it from going into the carburetor. And it should have plenty of flow, even though it's only gravity feed, to be able to feed this little four cylinder. So, but right now I need to get this carburetor off here and get it cleaned out. So, let's get that off. Cotter pin didn't want to come out. Last thing I want to do is have to drill that sucker out. Important not to drop any bits down through this intake. A lot of engines get destroyed that way. Keep track of your parts. Well, here's the carburetor off that little pony motor. Cute little cast iron. I think it's a marble of some kind. Anyway, you can see all the dirt up in there. So get this part and get it cleaned out. Crusty. I'm going to take this down to the shop and hit it with the air compressor real good. It's probably clean enough where it would run, but I want to be sure I get all the goop out of here. So hopefully I won't have to do this again for a while. I don't like having to work on it before I can start it. Alright, let's put this carb back on here. Thank you. these screws got, or nuts got to go on as the carb goes down. Not enough room to screw them off the studs all the way. One on the back side is really hard to get to, so I'll run it down first. Do this one here last. Click, click. Click, click. Yep, they're good. Put some oil on these bolts. Put some on this dipstick. I don't want these broke off in the head later. Diesel engine oil on there, look how clean that is. My motor's burned tight. I got that oiled up. Maybe we'll try and seize up in there in the future. Well, gotta go find an O-ring and a pipe plug. I'll be back. Here comes the inspector to make sure the job is okay. What do you think? Looks like it'd be okay. I think it ought to run.
Yep, looks like the boss is satisfied I quit making noise.
Well, I hope you enjoyed getting to see me go through this carburetor and get this tractor running again. So, get through a little planning for a change instead of all work. And hopefully this fall, if it stays fairly dry like it has, you can do some fall tillage with this. Hook it up to the tool plow and do a little field work. Maybe get you some video of that if you'd be interested in it. So, thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing. I'll catch y'all later.